Hey guys, in this lesson, we're going to create a simple serverless application that uses a couple of application integration services, SNS and SQS, as well as Lambda. So the application will include SNS. What we're trying to simulate here is that an application is sending a notification to a topic, and then we want that information to be processed, and we want to do so in a decoupled fashion. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to enter the information manually into the SNS topic. So you can just assume if it was a real world use case, then an application would be sending that information rather than us going into SNS and manually sending a message. But once the message has been sent using SNS, it's going to be forwarded to an SQS queue because we're going to subscribe to the SNS topic using the queue. Once it's in the queue, SQS is actually going to trigger an AWS Lambda function, which will then process the message from the queue. And it's going to simply write some information to CloudWatch logs so we can go and validate that it actually ran successfully. So that's the simple application. In the AWS console, what we need to do first, let's create our SNS topic. So head across to SNS. What we're going to do, I'm just going to use the feature from the left here. Go to topics, create topic. It's going to be a standard topic. And I'm just going to call this send notification. Scroll down, don't need to change anything, just create the topic. That's all we need to do here. Next, we need to head across to SQS. Let's open the simple queue service and we're going to create a queue. It's also going to be the standard option here. And we'll just call this my SQS queue. Scroll down, leave all the defaults here. And then we're just going to click on create queue. So now we have the queue as well. In here, what we can do is we can subscribe to the SNS topic. So let's go ahead and do that. Subscribe to Amazon SNS topic, select the topic, this is the one here, and click on save. So now we have that element done. Next, we need to create our Lambda function. So let's open up the Lambda console, click on create a function. It will be a Python function. So I'm going to use the latest Python runtime, whatever number that is. And I'm going to call this my serverless function. Now we have some code, so in the course download, in the Amazon SQS directory, you'll find this file, lambda code snssqs.py. So copy all of this code. All it's going to do is just process the information from the SQS message and then output that information into CloudWatch logs. So what we can do over here, we can just come down and create the function. And once the function's created, we're going to paste in our code. Okay, the function has been created. Let's come in and just paste our code and then click on deploy. Now, our function will need some permissions to be able to process the message from the queue. So what we need to do is head across to configuration, come down to permissions, and then click on role name here, the actual URL. That takes us across to the IAM console. And what we need to do is add an additional permissions policy. So click on add permissions, attach policies. And if I just search for SQS, here is the AWS Lambda SQS queue execution role. Very important we do this before we set up the trigger. So click on add permissions. And now we've got this additional policy statement. So you can see here, this is going to allow SQS receive message API, delete message, get queue attributes, create log group in CloudWatch logs, create log stream, put log events. Now, I think we already have the logging in the basic execution role here because we already have what we need there. This permissions policy gives us these additional SQS actions that Lambda can then use to process the message. Great, so we have everything set up now except for our trigger. So coming back to the SQS console, click on Lambda triggers, configure Lambda function trigger, and then simply select your Lambda function and then click on save. Now that should be everything set up. So coming back to the diagram, we have an SNS topic. We're going to manually send a message, a notification from the topic. The queue is subscribed to the topic, and the queue is going to trigger the Lambda function when it receives messages. So it's basically going to tell Lambda there's a message here for you to process. Lambda then needs some permissions, which we've already assigned, in order to be able to pick up those messages from the queue, process them, and it's going to then write an entry to CloudWatch logs. So let's go and test this out. We need to go to the SNS console here, and if we find our topic, we can click on publish message. We can give it a name, my serverless app, and then a message body, sending a message from SNS. And then if we just scroll down, publish message, that should trigger the entire serverless application. So of course, this is event driven. So SNS is going to send to the SQS queue because the SQS queue has subscribed to the topic. And then SQS is going to trigger Lambda. Lambda is going to pick up the event. It's going to process the information and then write an entry to CloudWatch logs. So with any luck, what we should have now, if we go to the monitor from the Lambda function here, click on the monitor tab, and then click on view CloudWatch logs. And we should find that we have a log stream. Here it is. And here we've got some information. And within this information, I can clearly see subject my serverless app message, sending a message from SNS. So that is the application working successfully. So that's it for this video. All you need to do to clean this up, you can keep your topic if you wish to. It's not costing you anything. You might need to use it in the future, or feel free to clean it up. Delete your queue and delete your function.